Hello students, welcome to this video lecture on engineering curves. I, Anthony Augustine, in this video would be discussing the topic of Archimedean spiral. Following is the problem statement. Construct an Archimedean spiral for one convolution with greatest and least radii of 120 and 20 mm. So as per this problem, the curve traced is Archimedean spiral. And the data given is that the outer radius of the spiral, that is OA, is 120 mm and the inner radius or the least radius OB is 20 mm. So with this data, we'll be constructing an Archimedean spiral for one convolution in clockwise direction. So we start with a circle having center O and we'll divide this circle of a radius 60 mm into 12 equal parts. But remember, 120 mm might not come in your sketchbook. So in actual problem solving, I would be taking the scale. However, here in this PPT, I'm just explaining the concepts. So here, the overview of the problem, I would be needing a circle of radius 120 mm. I'll be dividing the circle into 12 equal parts and the center of the circle is point O. Point A represents the outermost radius point. So OA here is 120 mm. On this, I take a point B, which is at a distance of 20 mm from the center. Now, since the Archimedean spiral is to be made for one convolution in clockwise direction, I'll be naming the points in clockwise direction as shown. Next, I have taken 12 steps. As you can see, 0 is the starting and 12th is the last step, which coincides because I'd be covering one rotation about the pole A. Hence, I'll be taking only 12 steps. If this would have been a problem of 1.5 convolution, I would have taken further more steps, that is 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay. So here for one convolution, I'll be just covering from 0 to 12. Then I have to cover the distance from B to A in one convolution. So I'd be taking 12 divisions for on the circle. So I would be dividing this distance equally into 12 divisions also. So I take 12 divisions on the horizontal and name them starting from point B, which is the starting point. So B is the starting point and the other divisions I have named up to the last division 12 dash, as can be seen. Next, I take an arc with pole O as the center. I place the compass at point O and then with radius 0 to 1 dash, I'll be drawing an arc onto the line joining O with 1. So this will give me point P1. Similarly, with pole O as the center and radius O to 2 dash, I'll be drawing an arc and finding the intersection with the position 2, and this is point P2. For the remaining points, I'll be doing the same and I'll be getting point P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11 and 12. 12th point lies on A itself, point A itself. So I'll be getting the points on the Archimedean spiral, which I'll be joining by a dark continuous curve. So this was the brief overview of the problem. Now, actually I'll be solving in the sketchbook the problem using half scale, because we can't draw a circle of 20 4 centimeter diameter in a normal small page sketchbook. So we take a scale, half scale I am taking. So these are the details that are given. I draw a horizontal line first, and because I am taking a scale of 1:2, that is half scale, I'll be marking a distance of 12 centimeters and finding the center, and with 60 mm as the radius, I'll be drawing the circle. So I have taken half the dimension value. So instead of radii 120, I am taking radius of 60 mm. Next, I divide the circle into 12 equal parts. Okay, the construction remains the same, only the dimensions I am taking, all the dimensions that I'll be taking would be half. So I take angles at 30 degrees and join it with the center to divide the whole circle into 12 equal parts. So now I have obtained the division of the circle, because this point has been named OA. So I'll take O as the pole and A as the outermost radius. Now I'll mark the position of point B. So I'm taking half a scale, so I'll be taking 10 mm on my compass. So I've taken 10 mm distance from the center and marked point B. Next, what I'll be doing is I'll be dividing the distance BA into 12 equal parts. I start the naming on the outer circle first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, because I am taking only one convolution, so only 12 steps. So I'll be covering distance B to A in 12 equal steps. So I need to divide B to A, so I use a line at an acute angle. I take uniform divisions, 12 uniform divisions, and mark it on the inclined line as can be seen. Next, I'll be joining the 12th division with the point A. Okay, so I have drawn the inclined line from point B. Remember, from B to A, I have to divide into 12 equal parts. So therefore, I am drawing acute angle line from point B. And now I joined the 12th division with A, and to that line, I draw parallel through all the other divisions as can be seen. So my distance B to A is divided into 12 equal parts. I'll provide the name from 1, 2, 3, 4 as can be seen on the horizontal divisions with a dash notation. So now I need to draw the admittance spiral starting from B in clockwise direction. So I am providing the direction of rotation of spiral. Now with pole O as the center and 1 as the radius, as can be seen, O1 as the radius, I transfer it to position 1. And here I find on position 1, that is the line through position 1 on the circle, P1. Now same, I take distances for 2 and now for 3. About the pole, I am taking distances and getting P1, P2, P3 accordingly. Now about pole, I am taking up to 4, marking on 4. From 5, I have marked on 5, 6, I have transferred to line 6, 7, I have transferred to line 7, 8 I have transferred to line 8, 9 I have transferred upwards, 10 I have transferred on the line through 10, and 11th I have transferred on the position 11. 12th is on the circle itself. So remember, radius I am taking about pole O to the respective points and marking on the line with the respective numbers. Now with B as the starting point, I draw a curve passing through all the points I have found. So I use the edge of the French curve, join two points at a time. And this is how I would be completing the whole Archimedean spiral. So this would be the final curve that I would be getting by joining all the points. Remember, the 12th point is point A itself, which is the final point. And this is the final curve. So I hope you understood the problem, and don't forget to write the name of the curve, Archimedean spiral, for one convolution. So this is the given solution, and this is the final output that was needed. So hope you are able to solve this problem using this video. Thank you for your patient listening.